Hi, thank you for joining us today for our Gigabyte Talk. My name is Liam and I'm part of the Gigabyte marketing team for enterprise products. And today I want to share with you some of our GPU accelerated servers that have an ARM-based CPU. As well, these systems will be used in HPC and AI applications. And thanks to the NVIDIA excellent level of hardware and software ecosystem of the NVIDIA accelerators, they are able to use them by data scientists, researchers, and industries such as finance or even retail market. So, because the hardware is such an important factor, today I will spend time talking about three servers by Gigabyte. They all use a high core count CPU, and they're used for diverse applications in AI and cloud. As well, they are known for a high level of parallel processing and have support for BlueField DPUs. It might go without saying, but I need to mention Gigabyte's position in the enterprise market. We are a hardware-based company, so our solutions are always hardware-based. So, Gigabyte has been manufacturing motherboards for 30 years and has been in the server market for 20 years and has been a top manufacturer during the whole time. As well, customers have come to us for ODM Direct data center solutions, and we have delivered. And today I want to share with you three of our servers. The first two are based for HPC and AI applications as they use PCI cards such as the NVIDIA A100 or A40. And the third server is our edge server that could be used for inference or other edge applications. And it supports the BlueField DPUs. First, I want to talk about the design of these new servers we have today. They use ARM-based processors, namely the Ampere Ultra processor, and these have applications in cloud services by AWS to Azure.
On the left is our G242P32 that was chosen by NVIDIA to support the NVIDIA ARM HPC Developer Kit for evaluating and benchmarking HPC and AI applications. And on the right, we have the E252P30. That is a small form factor edge server and can accommodate many low profile T4 cards.
I trust by now you've heard of and may even be using the Ampere Ultra processor, which leverages the high core count with cloud and edge applications. Moving from x86 to ARM for the cloud is right with Ampere Ultra. Ampere has specifically designed the chip for cloud and edge. The new chips have all the features one would expect and want in 2021. PCI Gen 4, 100 plus PCI lanes, 8-channel memory, support for 3200 DDR4, and so forth. We say it has predictable performance because of the high core count, up to 80 cores, the large cache available, and the PCI Gen 4 for throughput. Second, it has scalability. Adding more 1U or 2U servers will be easy, thanks to the high core count giving Ampere a dense ratio of cores per rack. And there are single or dual socket options. Last is the power efficiency. For our high-end 250-watt range CPUs that have 40 or 60 cores, Ampere outnumbers them and does so without the amount of power. Also, Ultra has advanced power management to adjust to workloads and improve TCO. Just recently, NVIDIA announced the first ARM server validated by NVIDIA to be used with NVIDIA GPU and DPUs. It has been dubbed the NVIDIA ARM HPC Developer Kit, and it was done in this Gigabyte G242 chassis. The server comes with two NVIDIA A100 cards and two BlueField 2 cards for safe and efficient scaling. And more importantly, at the heart of it all, the 80-core Ampere Ultra processor. This dev kit has support for NVIDIA HPC SDK, which is a suite of GPU accelerated compilers and libraries for compute intensive applications. The Ampere Ultra platform is able to efficiently scale with high performance and high level of instructions. The two G242 models we have today are the G242P31 that is for heterogeneous computing and the G242P32 that is tailored for the NVIDIA ARM HPC Dev Kit. The G242P31 was introduced earlier this year. It is GPU-centric and supports four NVIDIA A100 accelerators that are PCI Gen 4 by 16 slots for impressive throughput. And orchestrating the server is the Ampere Ultra processor with 16 DIMMs for 8-channel memory. For storage, there are 4 3.5-inch hard drive or 2.5-inch SSD hot swap bays for SATA SAS drives to allow for high storage capacity, yet option for SSD speeds as well. On the rear, we can see 3 low-profile Gen 4 expansion slots for networking or storage. And at the back are 2 80-plus platinum 1600-watt power supplies. Next up, we have the G242P32. However, I need to give some context first. When NVIDIA needed a powerful computing platform for developers, they came to Gigabyte as we were able to deliver a server quickly, all while checking off all the boxes. For it, we adopted our G242 to accommodate the hardware for the NVIDIA ARM HPC dev kit. And that includes support for 2 full-height, full-length NVIDIA A100 accelerators using Gen 4 by 16 lanes. And although there are 4 slots, only 2 are operational and needed. And again, we are seeing a single socket for the Ampere Ultra CPU with 16 DIMMs. For storage, there are again 4 SATA SAS bays at the front for easy access. And because of the initial launch by NVIDIA and subsequent success of the Software Development Kit SDK ecosystem or suite, NVIDIA made the kit more accessible. So Gigabyte ushered out the G242P32 specifically for the dev kit. And one of the distinguishing bits is that of the expansion slots, 2 are for the NVIDIA BlueField 2 DPUs. In one other slot is the HBA card, and that leaves 2 low-profile slots for networking, as we expect customers to choose their own LAN cards. Now, shifting gears, we are going to step away from the G24 that is purpose-built for GPU-accelerated workloads and look at an edge inference server, the E252P30, that is designed for low-profile cards such as NVIDIA T4, with GDDR6 memory. This type of inference server can be found at the edge and needs real-time data processing. Here we are looking at an Intel server, the E251U70, that is used in the NVIDIA Aerial Developer Kit. I point this out because it has the common design that we see in the E252P30, and ARM is using this server in the ARM 5G Solutions Lab to evaluate technology needed for 5G base station deployment. The E252P30 has the same single socket support for Ampere Ultra processor and can accompany up to 16 DIMMs for up to 4 terabytes of system memory. For this edge server, there are 6 2.5-inch SATA SAS hot swap bays and 2 M.2 Gen 4 slots. As we said, this server is perfect for inference work. At the rear are 6 low-profile expansion slots, with all being Gen 4. So, it's perfect to be populated with multiple T4 cards, which can handle content recognition to AI video applications, and with low latency edge performance. Simply put, Gigabyte has servers ready for fast time to market and GPU accelerated workloads from HPC to AI. So today I want to thank you again for your time learning about our servers and that have these HPC and AI applications, as well as I want to mention about the future, because we do have some dual socket Ampere Ultra processor servers coming out that support the new 128-core Ampere Ultra Max CPU. For more information, you can reach us at gigabyte.com/enterprise. Or email us directly at server.grp@gigabyte.com. Thank you very much.